How do I say? The Mahatchukung in itself is what you could call a Confucian Qigong training. Historically, until the Ming Dynasty, Confucians did not do exercise, period. But what they did, they were trying to train how they would appear, well, what they would look like. So they tried to control their appearance, just like they would try to control their feelings, and try to become as lofty as possible. And the posture of that is also used in Taoism to describe this is how the immortals in heaven walk. So the official posture of a Confucian official is also the posture of the gods in the Taoist heaven. So, Qigong practice in itself is a Taoist thing. Only from the period of Neo-Confucianism, Confucians were allowed to do meditation, exercise and stuff like this. And the whole process of things like Tai Chi Chuan and Qigong actually started rolling because of the influence of Neo-Confucianists. The metaphor that is used for how a person should stand is that of bamboo. That's why the Qigong is called a bamboo Qigong. So it's to help you develop a good body posture, to develop a correct. And as you know, bamboo is built from joints, and just like our arms and legs are being built from the same things. And because of this way of building, the tightness of the joints makes that if the wind blows, the bamboo goes left and right, but always bounces back to wherever it goes to. And I don't know if you ever seen the roots of bamboo. Okay. Well, the roots of bamboo is just like our feet and our toes. It spreads out, and it spreads out not very deep in the earth, but it spreads out so wide that it's almost impossible to get the bamboo out of the earth. And it's very similar in the way how, like, for instance, a lotus flower grows. The lotus flower, the seed goes into the water. The stem goes into the water, and in the bottom you have the root. But the root has several layers underground, and it spreads out. So you can never uproot the lotus flower. Yes? And if you see rye is we call this a buckwheat, one particular kind of grass that is also used to make bread and stuff like this. If you look at that, they also have like three layers of roots underground, and they spread out very wide, and it's impossible to kill it. And the bamboo works in a similar way. In the roots, they spread out in everything. I had a storage space in my garden in the other city, other house that I lived. In the Zaandam, and the bamboo went underground and came to the storage place and went all the way into the wooden walls and was breaking down basically the house because of the way how the roots were growing in there. It was amazing how that actually functioned. So this is a very strong part. This is the part of your feet. And your feet are like as if they're underground, so they basically spread out over the floor, right? So you keep your toes a little bit wide and a little bit pressed to the floor. To do like that. You stand on your heels, just like with the other exercises, that's the same. And you try to make as long as possible. And there's actually 6 points which are relevant for that, and 3 points are major points. These are called the three gates. We talked about it last week also. That's the base of the skull, behind the heart, and between the kidneys. And you lift these ones up so that the joints, they are really as flexible as possible, that they don't all the time flap like the hinges of a door, right? So they are not like hinges, but they are like they're being held together a little bit like this, so that your back bounces a little bit. So the movements that we make, they are based on the fact that the back all the time is straight, and that we try to move the body around left and right and so forth and forward and backwards in a way that allows us to root deeper into the earth and to feel more, how do you say, comfortable is a good word, that we feel more connected, right? Connected is the word. That's the basic principle of Jing, Jing is based on the fact that all the different body parts are intertwined and connected. That's what the word Jing comes from, is intertwinement or wefts. And it is used by Confucians to designate the books that are considered elementary to understanding the Confucian thinking. And that's why they're usually seen in the West as classics. They're not really classics, they're seminal works, right? So they're not classics, but they're like seminal works. It's like you go to cinema, some movies, they show you how to make a movie. It's a seminal work. And with some books also, they explain you what to do. This, what I'm now doing is what you can call the Jing talk, because I explain some basic elements. And I show you the different parts that are intertwined in the story, so that the practice actually becomes clear. Yolanda, this is different than what I used to explain in the past, right? A little bit. Yeah. Speakers off. It's always good to keep your speakers on if not necessary, so that you can immediately respond.
I wanted to say yes, but no, it's just that she's quite shouting, so...
No, that's okay. I understand why you do it, no problem. Dimitra has a cat that's all the time, meow, 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 meow.
Just... Yeah, actually, he's quiet at the time.
Yeah, no, I'm just joking. My cat was begging the whole morning for food because I changed the food. And she doesn't like the food.
Je mag deze puzzel afmaken.
It's biological food. Unfortunately, she doesn't like that because the taste is less strong than the non-biological food. Yeah. It's like people eating spices. They don't like real foods because they like the taste of the spices. And with the bamboo qigong also, the movements itself is a little bit like spices or like strengthened food. It is all very basic. It's very simple. There's nothing very exciting about the movements. It's all about making sure that everything stays calm on the inside. So it is the exercises are relatively bland. And the excitement is in the changes that happen on the inside in your body. The main thing in the exercise is that you pay attention to the outer form of your body. The inside of your body is completely not relevant. The things that you feel floating through your arms or in your body or something like this, or even the location of the dantian is not that relevant. Most important is the way how you stand on the floor and how you develop the outer form of your body to make the movement proper. You understand? At the moment when you're standing in the bamboo qigong, the range of your movements actually is about this, right? So it's not much. You understand? This is about it. Your feet, when they're on the floor, they're just standing on the same position. Nothing really changes, and most of the movements are done with straight legs. There's only at the beginning of the exercise, there's something that you go down, and the rest is all in straight legs. So the whole time, you're just this bamboo that goes up and down, front, and so on and so forth. So nothing really changes. And you really try to... I don't know anymore which one to choose to talk to. So, when people talk about rooting, this is basically what they talk about. Talk about rooting as being connected to the floor. And the reason for that is because they say in Taoism that all creatures try to get to heaven. And at the moment when you let go of the earth, you start flying about, you become too hot, and you lose your mind. Because nobody can understand heaven. Right, so when you come too close to heaven, you have a feeling like you're close to it, but in fact, you're very far away from it because there's no connection. You need that connection to the earth to be able to comprehend at a certain point what's happening around you. So this is one of the basic elements that is essential in the bamboo qigong. So all the movements are based like that. Qing is usually translated as essence in English by many people. And although it's essential, it is not exactly what it means. I used the way how Jing is being used by the Confucians is classic. While it in fact means a weft, it's the way how things are intertwined. Your body is built from all kind of tissues, and these tissues they intertwine in a particular kind of way. And this is how your body develops a particular kind of coherence. And when you develop more and more understanding of this coherence, your Jing becomes stronger. If your Jing becomes stronger, automatically your body can produce qi. And when the chi becomes stronger, because it is more clear, then automatically your consciousness also grows. That's basically the root of alchemy, right? That's the we call this in Taoism, it's being called working with the three treasures. And Confucianism, you don't have that part. It's about the improvement of the whole physiological process.
Now I have a lot of questions.
Start somewhere.